common words that mean something more specific to experts. We use the word hearsay in the way we use rumor, to cast doubt on a statement. When we say, "That's just hearsay," we mean, "That's just things people are gossiping or guessing about." But as a legal term, it's something more specific. Hearsay evidence is a statement made in court where the witness is reporting what someone else said, but that person is not in court and so can't be questioned or evaluated as credible. Don't use the passive is common advice for improving your writing. If you say, "Mistakes were made," you are avoiding naming the one responsible for the mistakes and weaseling out. But you can weasel out just as well without using passive voice at all. Grammatically, passive voice is when what would ordinarily be the object of a verb shows up as the subject, and the verb takes a form with a past participle, like "were made." But there are plenty of other ways to avoid naming responsible parties, such as, "People are saying that someone made a mistake," or "Mistakes happen." These are weaselly sentences, but not passive ones. If something is significant, it's important, right? Not necessarily. When experimenters say a result is statistically significant, it only means that the result is very unlikely to be just a fluke. So if you measure the height of 1 million people and find that those who eat broccoli 3 times a week are on average 1 millimeter taller than those who do not, and it meets the test of statistical significance, you can be pretty sure that the difference you have found exists. But the difference may not be important at all. Toxins in the air, in the water, in our food. The word toxin, with its scientific ring and scary X in the middle, has become a general way to say stuff that's bad for us. But not everything we call a toxin meets the scientific definition. Toxins are biologically produced substances like snake venom or the stuff that makes a mushroom poisonous. They are produced by living organisms. Lead, mercury, asbestos, and synthetic flame retardants do not fall under this definition. This type of thing has a slightly different name, toxicant. We use work to mean exertion or effort. If your job is to push against a boulder to keep it from rolling down a hill, no matter how heavy the boulder is or how much you're tiring yourself out, it's not, in the physics sense, work. Work is force applied to an object that moves the object in the direction of the applied force. Pushing a boulder up a hill? Now, that's work. We sometimes use evolution or the verb evolve to refer to situations of improvement, progress, moving toward something better. It's good to be evolved, right? But the scientific definition of evolution has no particular goal or quality of goal in mind. It means change over successive generations in inherited genetic traits. This will usually mean things get better adapted to whatever the local conditions are, but that's not the same as progress towards some ultimate perfect good.